Hello, welcome and welcome to my channel. Today's topic, we're talking about two extreme cases regarding option valuation. I'm wondering what's the option value would be if implied vol or maturity goes to infinity. So before we go to the math part, I usually like to guess the answer by intuition. We know that the call is an option to own the underlying asset at maturity, so its upper bound should be equal to underlying price. And we also know that the higher vol, the higher option value, and also the longer maturity, the higher option value. So I guess if implied vol or maturity goes to infinity, the call option would be equal to the underlying asset price. So it's very close to underlying, it's the same as the underlying. And now let's dive into the math part. And our math is under the Black-Scholes framework. So recall the Black-Scholes formula for call option, European call option. So we have a European call option which is equal to the underlying asset price at time 0 and ND1. So by the way, N is the CDF of the standard normal distribution, and minus K, which is the strike price, times the discounting factor, times ND2. All right. And don't forget the D1 and D2. So for D1, we have a loan, your underlying price at time 0 divided by K, and plus R plus 1/2 of sigma squared, and times the maturity over the sigma times the square root of capital T. So that's the D1, and the D2 will be equal to D1 minus square root of capital sigma times square root of capital T. Alright, so that's the Black-Scholes. And we let the sigma goes to infinity, or more accurately, positive infinity, and we let the capital T goes to positive infinity. So D1 here, D1 will be equal to the scale of 1/2 of sigma times the square root of capital T, and D2 in the same, similarly, so it's in the same scale of negative 1/2 of sigma times the square root of capital T. So in both cases, whether sigma goes to positive infinity or the maturity goes to positive infinity, D1 will goes to positive infinity and D2 will goes to negative infinity. So in this case, ND1 will be close to 1 and ND2 will be close to 0. So now we have the final answer. So your call option will be equal to S0, which is your underlying asset price at time 0, which is the consistent with our guess before. All right, so I think that's it for today's video. This short video will give some insight and a deep understanding of the derivative. So from intuition, the derivative is an option for owning an underlying asset if the implied vol or maturity goes to infinity. Your derivative actually becomes an underlying asset, so there's no difference between owning an option or own underlying asset. So that's the intuition behind this math. All right, hope this short video will give some insight to the derivative. If you like this video, please give me a thumb up and leave your comment below, or you can subscribe my channel. And thanks for watching. See you next time.